welcome to an extended episode of Pacesetter FC The Journey. We are here today at Spencer FC, which will be doubling up as our home ground for the forthcoming season. The facilities here include a home and away dressing room, and the pitch is definitely an improvement on what we have been playing on so far. Today, you're going to see an extended highlights of an 11v11 game and seeing if the boys can put into practice what they have learned so far. The lads are currently warming up to get themselves ready. Unfortunately, we have two players who have dropped out, Leo and Riley. And two of the existing members of the squad, Peter and Elijah, couldn't make it today. But on the other hand, we have some like-for-like replacements to replace them for this 11v11 game. We have Mason, Kenny and Kelvin. I also have a special guest on today's episode, my under-12s keeper, William. He's filling in goal today for one of the teams, as I only have one goalkeeper in the present squad. We have a special guest with us today, co-commentating with myself, and we've got the producer of Applewood, Dama James. How are you, Dama?
I'm very well, thank you, and you're very kind. So I'm looking forward to seeing this match, their first 11-11 V game. Do you know what? I nearly fell off a stepladder filming this the other day. Thank you, Storm Gareth.
Ooh, check out episode 2.
Awesome. Right.
So team 1, Kyle is the captain. He is in goal. He's got Marc, Nathan, Zab and Gab in defence. Got Marvin, Amechi and Renato in midfield. Mason, Liam and Iman lead the attack with Kelvin on the bench. Team 2's captain is Zubi. He's got Will, the under-12 keeper. With Harry, Kai, Carlos and Gids in defence. He's got Elliot, Omar and himself in midfield with Timmy, Rowell and Abdul leading the attack with Kenny on the bench for them today. Both teams are lining up in a 4-3-3 situation like we've been working on in training. So how do you feel personally, Dama, the players have got on so far?
I think you've got a good selection there, good squad. I think you'll be sad to see some of these lads go because, you know, they've put a shift in every week. Some of them have actually, you know, they've taken some hard tackles. Others have actually done really, really well, exceeded my expectations, certainly just observing it. But I think, you know, some people have to go. And whoever leaves now, I'm sure they'll have a future with football being a big part of it.
Of course, of course. Who's been your personal favourite so far, especially in these 22 players?
Well, I don't really have favourites, but I think between Peter and Emmanuel, they certainly do really, really, really well in, you know, episode 1 and episode 2. I think even in the trailer, you can see their performances. But I think all of them do well. I mean, the strikers do well, and obviously we're off. Midfielders do well, and Gideon, his pace is just...
He's electrifying, isn't he?
Mad.
Well, it's been a good start so far from the non-mibs. They're knocking it about really well, especially what we've been working on in training. An early corner from
good
the...
Good corner.
Oh, it's a great ball in from Omar. Bit of communication there. Needed there, I think, then it could have led to something. But Omar's done well again to cause trouble. Timmy, in my personal opinion, has caused a lot of trouble so far.
Oh, ball's in. Emeshi just got it out.
Good interception from Kai. They're breaking Iman.
Ah, brilliant pass. Oh, was he offside or not?
Nah.
Liam. Oh, he shoots. Liam has tucked it away.
Yes, Liam tucked it away. He's been a threat up front so far with his goals and assists.
He's got pace.
He's got pace to burn. Defenses.
Oh, here he goes again. Here he goes. Oh, Zubi just... Is that Zablon? No, that is Zubi. That's a pen.
Never a pen.
That's a pen.
Never. He won the ball.
No, he didn't.
He won the ball.
Okay, fair enough.
He won the ball. He won the ball.
All right. So, Carlos going to play it out from the back.
I've been impressed with Carlos. I've liked Carlos.
Yeah, I like Carlos. The lads seem to like him as well.
There's been a lot of...
This Mason, that's the new kid. Oh, here's Liam again in the box. That's it.
Oh, good scramble from him.
Kai's following him. Puts it back to the wing. So Gideon, it's going to be an interesting battle, Gideon and Mason.
No one's going to get past Gideon. No one gets past Gideon.
No one gets past those thighs, mate.
Look at them thighs. Chicken wing thighs.
That's Marc. What's he doing so deep?
He's playing right back today.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Oh, Ronaldo's just made Omar look silly. Look at that play.
Oh, good save by Will. Eman goes there. Oh, another block by Kai. Emechi, a couple chances there.
Emechi's done well so far.
And Zablon kicks it in. Right, here we go again. Carlos puts it out to the wing, finds Timmy.
Timmy. Good battle between these two, Marvin and Timmy. Both got strength and pace.
Yeah.
Be interesting to see these. Marvin's come up better there, though. Timmy tried to battle back. Emechi. Mechie's looking for a pass.
He's looking at his options.
I've been impressed with Mechie so far in this game.
He's good, definitely. All intercepted by Mr. Thigh himself.
Mason again.
This is a mismatch, but this kid's got some... Oh!
He's turned Gideon inside.
Oh, brilliant. He's got it away. Got it away.
Gideon needs to recover, but Zuby...
Yeah, Gideon's going to break his legs, though.
Not many people get past Renato, but Marvin clears up well.
In the middle. So Elliot's got the ball, looking for options.
Gids.
He's going to drive. He likes to drive forward. I think if you've seen
look at Zuby
a few
there.
Days, Gideon likes to go forward. So Zuby's gone. Ruel's first touch. Gets the ball.
Amechi again. I've been really impressed with Amechi.
Zablon out on the wing. Mason.
That's a ball there. Free kick. Zablon's going to look to play it short there. Mason again gets involved. Renato's
driving.
With his, he's so good on the ball though, Renato.
So comfortable. Good. That close to the sort of the 18-yard line. And he's just really, really sort of comfortable.
Marvin in a new position. He doesn't really used to play him, but...
See, he always does that move where he gets the ball and he just goes forward, looks up, sees his options, and then he just gets it in the box somehow.
Omar's
doing his job.
Amechi causing problems. Amechi doesn't surprise me if he gets a goal in this game.
Ruel nearly got it to Timmy.
Good from Omar. Zablon with a good head. Timmy again. Look at Timmy. With his pace and his strength. Oh, that's a free kick. Who's going to take the free kick? Oh, Gids is going to go. Oh, he's gone early, though.
Yeah.
The non-bibs need to be about.
Timmy's in.
What a touch. What a...
Oh! Yes, Timmy. Good goal, Timmy. Good
Kyle,
goal.
Kyle, no chance.
That's a wicked ball into the area, though. Very
great
good
spot
pass.
From Gids. That's Timmy's actually first goal so far for the team. Yeah. Like,
it was coming.
Trials.
It was a long time coming. Here he goes again.
He's made Gabriel look... Oh, my God. Gabriel's looked so... Zablon again. The composure of him, man.
Intercepted.
Gablon. Zablon's done well.
Did you just call him Gablon?
Zablon, man. Zablon.
Are you mixing Gideon and Zablon or Gabriel and Zablon?
Yes.
Zablon 27 players. People. Mason.
Mason again. Renato.
Renato. What's he going to do? Oh, just flicks it forward.
Timmy, no chance.
Goal scorers, like, what's going on? And he does it again.
Hey, Timmy. Come on, he needs to work harder there, though.
So, Renato, what's his options? Emmanuel.
Back to Renato.
They lose possession. So Timmy again. So Timmy's been busy down that right wing.
Did a lot of action today.
Yeah.
Elliot's got a dip over. Oh, what a ball from Elliot.
Well,
that's a fantastic ball.
Oh.
Good to see
Marc. Marc's in there and clears it. See, Marc, his stature, him and Nathan, they have a brilliant partnership in that defence.
They're both big. They're both fast. They're both strong.
Yeah.
And Mechie again. Mechie's caused a lot of problems. So is Marvin, to be fair. Marvin's been good
true,
in this game.
True. Ooh. Zablon's intercepted again.
Gabriel, I haven't seen a lot of Gabriel so far.
Yes, that's one of the replacements. Is that Kelvin?
Yeah, Kelvin's come on.
Yeah, there's Ruel going into the box. It's watched by Zablon, but he gets it out to Timmy. So Timmy's bringing it.
Oh, look at that.
Fancy kick.
Showing off for the cameras. He knew what he was doing. He knows
certainly
the camera
did.
Was there.
He certainly
Ronaldo
did.
Again, though, look. So good on the ball, so composed.
He's patient. He holds it up well.
And there's Nathan as well. Nathan's really
Nathan
good at the back.
Dunk. So he's going to get the ball. He's looking for options to his defensive partner, Marc. Mason's calling for it, but Marc goes down the middle.
Thing, though,
over Gideon. Good clearance by Kai.
Well
done.
In this thing. Mason with an early throw. Elliot's been good so far. Elliot's been strong.
Yeah. So here we go. Marc again is still up. So it's that Kai trying to get it away. Carlos gets it down. He's looking at his options. Ooh, and he spotted
Abdul. What can they do from this move, though, the Bibs? Abdul's on the ball.
Abdul's another one that reminds me of, I wouldn't say Makaleli, but just a player who's kind of aware of his surroundings. Definitely. And he gets it, switches up the play to the other side of the park.
Harry's got the ball on the right.
Yeah, Harry puts it forward to Timmy.
What's Timmy going to do? It's been dangerous all game. Elliot again.
You can see the build-up play. They're really thinking about this. Ooh.
Timmy's through. What's he going to do? Abdul!
2-1.
Zuby a 2-1 up.
Wow.
Abdul, that's that movement, like you said. That movement.
So they've come from a goal down.
They've come from goal down to
they have
back.
Indeed, yes. So 2-1. We're still in the first half. We're at Spencer, which is a much better ground than some of the others we've done. But, you know, it's the kids won't always, or the lads won't always choose what grounds they play at. So it's nice to have a variety.
Oh, lucky. Kelvin's done well, though.
Yeah.
He's replaced it. I think he's coming for Zuby.
Oh, yeah, I think you've taken Zuby off, and he's, I think, was Zuby injured?
Yeah, Zuby had a back injury
back
that game.
Problems, yes, he did.
It's a shame, though, because I don't see what... No, he's not. Zuby's on still.
Mason
I think he's coming for Eman. Eman's come on.
Is he? Mason's lost.
No, who's he? Omar's come off.
You can see him in the far end.
With, yeah, man.
Come on, Mark. It hasn't been that long since we did this game. You must remember how your subs. I hope you keep track of them.
I don't make the. I didn't make the subs in this game. The captains did. Timmy does well. Kelvin again. Oh, shut them legs, Marvin.
Oh. Mark. No, there's Zuby. Zuby's still on the pitch, as you say. Yes. So, Carlos, what's his option? So he's going forward and he gets it in the area. Mark again.
Big presence in there.
Someone in the wing brings it in. Ooh, Nathan. If it's not Marcus, Nathan. Oh, both of them again. Smack in the head. What's happening? Penno.
No. You can hear me in the background.
Oh, that was a penalty. I think both of them were. The Liam one and the Ruel one.
Emechi does well.
So we go forward. Emechi gets it forward. Liam's nearly got it. But Elliot's. Is that Harry?
Harry's in there. Gideon's coming out wide for it.
Oh, what's Will done? There's the inexperience. Mason's got it. Gideon gets in there.
Gideon's like, oh, look at his driving forward.
Here we go. He's not human, mate. I can see little wheels on those boots.
he's rapid, isn't he? Usain.
So Abdul's looking at his options. He's got Zuby. He gets it. Ooh.
Zuby's got a pass there.
He's got still got possession. Ooh, Mark. Crikey.
Mark. Got in there. Zuby's not having his day.
So this is Kenny, one of the Tekkers twins. Yes. Renato's off again.
What's Carlos doing there, though? He's lost his shape.
Mason's got it.
Again. Got the better kids.
I'll tell you what, some of these substitutes, they would give Elijah and Peter a run for their money. Or I would love to actually see them play together. What a save. Again. Oh, that's a short fit.
Mason there. 2-2, though.
Well done, Mason, but the keeper did a fantastic first save. On the follow-up, obviously, it was going to be difficult with no defenders in place to clear the ball.
Not going to lie, Mason deserves that goal.
Yes,
he does. So far. Had a good start.
Yeah. So, we're off. Again, what's that? 2-2.
2-2 at the moment.
2-2. 2-2. So, 4 goals in the first half. We haven't even gone to the prawn sandwiches in flying boots of halftime. And it's 4 goals in. It just tells you, and the tempo is quite high. What do you think?
I think the tempo is quite high considering this is their...
Oh, Timmy just went down there.
Considering this is their first, 11-a-side game together, properly.
Do you worry about burnout? You know, when you coach these players and by the 40th, 50th minute, they might be a bit fatigued and tired.
That's where the decision-makers...
Oh, what's Liam doing?
Lucky. But that's where the decision-makers got come in from the players and when they press.
Yeah.
They'll soon learn that. They'll soon get used to it when they play a couple of friendlies in before the season.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I've been impressed by them.
That's good. So, we've got Kai back to Gideon. Gideon's going to go down this left wing.
Oh, Gideon again. Oh. That pace and that strength, man. So composed on the ball, Gideon.
Yeah. So, Elliot gets it forward to Abdul.
Great first touch.
So
it's Anthony Martial down that left.
Bonjour.
Allez.
Okay. So Marvin's in there again. So Marvin's had a few intercepts.
He's meant to be a striker as well, but...
I know, he's doing a good job.
That strength and that pace.
Oh, nice intercept by Ruel there. Still got possession, looking for his options. He gets it out on the right wing to
Kelvin.
Kelvin takes the shot. Oh!
Kai was really first action.
Kai.
He hasn't really made a save today, but
yeah,
that's his first involvement really in the
game.
Well
done, Kai. Well done, Kyle.
But you can still hear his voice all the way down the pitch, though, which is fantastic.
Back to his mate. Who's this? So Liam. Oh, made it through to Liam. He connected.
Kenny.
Oh!
What a save from the under-12
keeper. Where did you find this kid?
This kid is phenomenal. His sister's better, though.
His sister's better?
Nah, I'm joking.
So he's he plays for another team?
Plays for my team.
Plays for your team?
The Pacesetter under-12 team.
Under-12s, and he's pulling out saves on the 16s. Well done, Will. Carry on.
Fair play, don't mind Mark.
He's just having a bit of banter, saying your sister's better than you.
Even his sister plays centre-back for me.
Wow.
She's phenomenal. Mason.
Nah, talented family. Right, so here's Nathan Dunk. We've got two Nathans.
The composure from Nathan there. Marvin.
So we're playing at Spencer, and you might be hearing the train going past with 1,700 million tons of coal. You know, the Northerners do need their heat.
It was a cold day, this one.
Yes,
I remember it very well.
I was just happy it wasn't windy. So E-Man gets it out to Liam. Liam, what's the options?
Liam's gonna cross it into Emechi. Oh, there it is. He deserves a goal. He's been well. He's been good today.
Yes.
It's been the best moments I've seen from him.
Well, so we're off again.
3-2 to the team Kyle.
Yes, Captain Kyle. They went 1-1, went 2-1 down, and they've gone back up to 3-2. And we're still in the first half. Five goals.
Fantastic.
So does that worry you when, you know, they're conceding so much? Yes, they're scoring, but they're also conceding.
I don't think it does. I'm not worried at all because some of these players obviously will not be playing for me when it comes to the 18, and they'll be coached on how to defend.
Yeah.
And some of these players are playing out of position, or they're playing in... They don't know how to defend, so they don't know the instructions.
Okay.
They will get used to it.
So you're just happy they're finishing?
I'm happy that they're linking up well.
There we go. Oh, that's just unlucky.
Omar.
Still in play.
Omar, strength against Mason. Oh, what? Oh, Kyle again. Well done, Kyle.
So you're just happy that they're... just back to what we were saying, that they're just obviously they're scoring and they're just linking up well. I can see they're using some of the final third combinations and even some of the moves you were teaching them, you know, like when they're pressing. Is it the half pitch press?
The half pitch press, yeah.
It's in effect.
It's coming in there, look.
Yeah.
We haven't worked on a lot of out of possession stuff, but we've worked on a lot of in possession building the play.
Yeah.
Which we will work on a lot of out of possession stuff, but the boys have done well so far.
What is this? It's offside. E-man. So here we go. E-man again. Ooh,
Carlos.
No. Carlos and Gideon.
Here's big five Gids. Oh, Omar, sit down. Yeah. Mason does well. Mason's had a really good
game. Someone please get Omar out of Mason's pockets, please? Love you, Omar.
Like that.
It's all right.
He's not going to like that. Harry does well.
And over to Timmy. Ooh.
Gabriel.
Is that Gabriel intercepts?
Renato again.
Here we go.
On that board.
Kenny. So Ronaldo is looking for his options.
Where's he going to go with the ball?
Oh, he's got it down there, and Harry's chasing it. Harry's got it. There we go. So
E-man's got the ball out wide on the right. E-man.
He must be hot in that hoodie.
It looks like he's got a bag on his back.
24-hour road man.
Of course he is. Look at him. Well, Ronaldo trying to summit spectacular there. The Olivier Giroud.
See, I'm impressed with Kenny, one of the Tekkers twins. His size. He can still hold the ball up well. He's aware of his surroundings. He knows where the other players are. Oh, this is a chance.
E-man not testing the keeper.
He's not going to be happy with
that.
He's
not happy because he loves scoring goals. We're into half-time now.
Well, here we go.
What's your opinion on half-time, first half so far?
Well, I think the cuisine could be better. But the first half. Apologies. So let's hear what they're saying. I'm just being left. I'll
go left wing. Mark, can we change the formation?
At top,
yeah.
You want to do at top, we need more support.
4-4-2, yeah?
Yeah.
So Royal has some suggestions.
Where's manager Zubi?
He's at left wing.
You're going left back? Yeah. Why?
Because Omar.
You no, like playing on like, this? Huh?
You like playing on this?
Yeah, I can play wing or centre-mid.
So you can see some of their skills emerging.
It's a leadership one I'm more interested in, which is
that
doing
the thing
well.
Is, yeah, you're really good at passing, that's why it's better for two at top.
You.
And you're good there, because you want to leave me in that pocket.
Kelvin. Ooh, and
big statement.
I don't say great to say left back, because you're pacey. And to be honest, yeah, Liam will destroy here. That's all the time where he runs around. He's got the pace.
No one else got the tactics board.
What I think should happen, yeah.
Obviously, so keep himself on.
Carlos and Kai, yeah, actually.
Yeah, keep it up.
Yeah, keep it as Carlos and Kai. Gideon, Harry, stay where you are because he's doing a good job, yeah.
Yeah, but it's not
all about that. We need to pass it to feet.
Yeah, I know, but you lot aren't passing.
Ooh, exactly. Disagreement between these two.
We can start doing that.
Zubi's getting annoyed now. Look at him. Look at the face of Zubi.
Yeah, let's keep that up. In midfield.
Next dressing room.
Mechie, Renato, Marvin.
Kyle.
Keep playing a ball in between you. Kenny and Emmanuel. Them runs down them lines, yeah? We could pick out that pass and then create a chance out of it. Pay it to Liam.
Looks interested.
Hopefully he finishes it. Put a lot more pressure on that player.
He's a natural leader, that kid.
I like him.
Yeah.
So if you put pressure on them...
Here comes the gaffer.
Isn't this biased?
I talked to both teams, actually. You didn't get me talking to both teams on camera about different stuff.
That's what our first goal came from. Great counter-attack.
Yeah.
Really fast.
They're too high. Yeah.
Nathan Dunk.
Sasha Bob. They're going to be out there shaking. You're going to get it back quickly, guys. Yeah.
When Liam pressure with the ball, shut down the
options. Nathan's had a really good game. Him and Marc. Him, Marc and Zablon, to be fair. Shut down the options, yeah.
And we're off again for the second half.
So yeah, your thoughts on the first half then, Dama?
Loads of goals. So yeah, I would have been concerned that they're conceding it, but your explanation of having not gone through some of the more, you know, advanced or intermediate. Wait, ooh, what we got here? Oh, nice touch.
Wonderful.
Anyway, as I was saying, I think your explanation of what, you know, what stage you're at with the lads in terms of defense, I think it's was clear, and I understand why you're not so concerned. I just thought, we've had five goals in the team, that we're trying to enter into a, you know, expectedly, competitively.
Yeah, of course.
Right. So, E-Man's taken his roadman jacket off. So he's got the Arsenal kit on.
Ronaldo passes the ball for once. Oh,
Liam's got the ball in the...
Liam. Kai again. Kai is on. Kai's on a good
corner
game.
In by Zablon.
What's the ball from Zablon?
Carlos with the header away.
Omar clears. Farah's Mason. Oh, no. Here's
Abdul.
Here's Anthony Martial.
Abdul's got it. Puts it down the middle. Elliot. So Elliot. Elliot's looking for options. Puts it down the wing to Omar again. Omar gets it from under his feet. Gets it to Abdul on the wing. Left wing. What are we going to do here?
Ruel.
Yes, Ruel's got it. So Marvin's on his case like a barrister.
Again, Zablon, Marvin's between them have done well. Renato. Kelvin, see you later, mate.
Kelvin, I've got a feeling there might be more of that to come later on. Don't know why. Kenny's got it. Gideon's like, I will just take that. Thank you very much.
Come on, chicken wing fires.
What do you think he orders when he goes to KFC?
Just the gravy and chips.
No. Would you like breast or thighs, please? No, I've got enough thighs. I have some...
breasts.
I have some breasts when he orders his KFC.
Bless him.
So, here's Renato again going down the middle.
Kelvin giving it. He's going to shoot,
isn't
poor.
He? Oh, Renato's not going to be happy with that.
It was Liam.
Was that Liam?
Nah, Liam's facial expression when Renato shot there instead of passed.
Yeah.
Kyle.
Strikers always want the ball. It's that natural instinct of I should be... Oh!
Does this lead to anything, though?
Where's this going? If this is a goal, then that is perhaps one of the best moves I've seen all series.
Oh! There we go. Kenny.
The new boy.
Oh, my word.
Iman Roach.
Iman. I like Liam for that. Going straight over to Iman. He started the move.
If that was Avengers, Kelvin would have been dusted.
Ooh.
Right. So, Gideon's got the ball.
Replay.
In the wing. I think we have to replay that. That one. That will be one that should be replayed.
Over and over again.
Yes.
Marvin again. He's done well.
He's done really well. And for a striker, he's helping out the midfield. Or for an attacker, sorry. He's helping out the midfield.
Nathan's gone right wing. I don't know why that. It's a questionable decision, to be fair. I would have kept him at the back. Oh. That's a foul.
You have to give Omar his credits for his determination, because Nathan Donk is not a pushover at all. He doesn't just stand there and let you barge into him.
Never.
And he does his job. They all do their job, to be honest. Oh, here we go.
Oh, Liam.
Ah, that's the second offside. So you haven't given the kid a penal, and you've called offside on him twice.
He's had a goal.
Is that how you look at it? Well, you've been all right, son. I'll just give the opposition the decision. I am only joking.
Bless him.
played behind him. Is he right-footed or left-footed?
I don't know what foot. I think he's a bit both.
That's another penal.
Never. Gideon's pure.
So how do you? What's your criteria for penalties? Because I would have said, here we go. Oh, that's just a wide.
In what way? What criteria?
Penalties. So what would have made you give it?
If it wasn't two teams trialing.
Okay.
Offside goal.
Is that offside?
Yes.
Oh, that's the third offside. But do you know what? They're being creative. I think if you're getting the ball in the back of the net, wouldn't you... Ronaldo with the...
Not many people stop Ronaldo.
That's a 12-year-old lad in goal.
Against stopping a 15-year-old lad.
Yes.
Who once had trials at Olympiakos when he was in Greece.
Wow.
Gideon there blocking Liam.
Well, this is Northampton Arcos now. He's doing well.
Yeah. Pacesetter Arcos. Nathan's carrying the ball.
Sounds like a dinosaur, mate.
Let's see Nathan's pace Nathan up against Dunk. Gideon. That'll be a good battle.
Gets the ball in.
Mason flicking on the smallest player on the pitch. Oh, he's gone for it.
Oh, that. Mr. Will had it covered. So, Ruel.
Riel. He's gone more deeper now to receive the ball.
Yeah. So, in terms of instructions on the pitch, once they set off, Marc, and this is just for the viewers, and they're doing their thing, how much more involvement do you have from the sidelines? Because we often see matches where managers are just sort of making gestures, send barking instructions, and you often wonder if it's just drama on the sidelines, to be honest. Is it effective? Oh,
I don't like it.
Yeah?
My personal opinion. Yeah, I'm like it more with my under-12s than I ever will be with my 15s.
Okay.
Because my under-12s probably need a bit more guidance on the pitch than my under-15s do.
Sure.
But I'm not going to give too much away. Wait there.
What are you we'll doing? Play. Oh, here we go. What's happening here? So what's the score so far? 3-2 to your...
The Bibs.
Bibs,
yeah. No. Yeah, 3-2 to the Bibs. No. Because Kenny scored, didn't he, just now? 4-2 to the Bibs. 4-2
yes.
to the Bibs.
4-2 to the Bibs, yeah.
Liam again.
Oh, what's happening? Why do I feel like there's a goal coming? I mean, I was there, but I don't remember. Oh!
E-Man again. E-Man's frustrated
Will.
Today.
Will Power. Let's call him Will Power from now on.
Gids. Oh,
Gideon's.
To Omar.
That was offside.
Nah.
Oh!
He missed anyway, though. He's not a striker, technically, but he needs to be doing something better there.
That ball's on a train to Birmingham New Street.
Ronaldo's now changed teams, if you see. Just because Zuby's had to come off. Caused a little bit of flair.
Yeah.
Oh, Omar again. How is he not?
Oh,
good pressure from Kyle, though.
That one's on its way to London, Euston. So, yeah, you do have some players who are consistent with applying pressure. And one or two players are perhaps remembering some of the training and the routines from day one, whether it's the rondo, the pressing, you know, the final third combination, holding the ball. They're doing really, really well.
Of course.
And you can see some of them shuffling like they did, excuse me, during the last episode where you had Emmanuel just going back and forth and he looked like he just needed a glass of water.
Or a, what do they do in the roadman street? The ghetto, what do they drink?
Listen, let's not talk about him. He's not a roadman, I'm sure. He's listening to this going, oh, come off it. Don't muck it. We'll take that out.
Timmy.
So Timmy's got the ball. What's Timmy about to do? Oh, who's
Ruel
taking a shot?
Ruel, man, he needs to be doing better there.
Ruel will improve. I think on the first day, I saw
Definitely.
A few moves in and off from him, knowing that he certainly has natural talent and ability. And you know, sometimes your position might impact your might have an impact on your impact in the game, I suppose. But here goes one of the new boys, Kenny. He's looking at his options. I thought he would have gone for Liam there, but. Is it too late? Yeah, the pass was too short. So, Emechi's got the ball to Kenny. And we have Abdul intercepting. And Mason. Good ball. Oh. Emechi again. So, Emechi, one of the goals. What's he doing now? He's just got it down to Emmanuel. He's got it. Gets the pass in.
He might have drilled that. If I was E-Man, that's got to be a drill across. He'll be learning a lot of that. But
yeah, he's had chances.
It's his decision making, though. He wants a goal.
Yeah.
Oh, Kenny. That's a Tekkers twins brothers.
Oh, there we
Getting
go again.
Nutmegged by two players now.
Wow. So,
here
we go.
Good.
Oh,
no.
He's lost possession. So, you've got Nathan.
No. Oh, no. That's awful defending.
Yes,
Gideon deserves a goal though. Big five.
So they lost.
Done well.
Marc lost possession.
And then Nathan lost possession after that.
Yeah.
Tired
so,
legs.
So what? What so is that? What you put it down to, or what suggestions would you have for the lads when they watch this back in terms of what they should have done better there?
For me, both of them, but should have probably scanned the options before they did it. Maybe put a bit of a harder passing, a bit more of a weight of passing involved, or just if they're not sure about passing it back. Carry it, keep the ball,
yeah.
Have your back to the player who's trying to press you, and you'll get a free kick out of it. But the decision making will come in time. For me, I think it's tired legs.
Yeah.
Getting used to the players. When they start getting used to each other, they'll know the distance of passes and they'll know the weight of it. But they'll definitely improve. They'll get used to it.
So do you think we're going to get a 4-0? I mean, seven goals so far.
Good. And a disallowed one, so eight.
Eight goals. That's incredible. I think one thing you can say is they are creating chances and they're getting the ball in the back of the net. I mean, you don't need two eyes to see that. But the lads are doing really well. I'm impressed so far by both sides. And I kind of am trying to determine who could be a man of the match. And it's difficult.
I'm
going to
let you choose that.
There might be men of the match. Oh!
Kelvin. No one pushes
Kelvin.
Carlos off. MMA Carlos.
Wow. Tired legs, I think that might be. But, you know, well done, Carlos, for... getting this far and, you know, not necessarily losing possession.
Timmy's on flames.
Wow.
Don't stop Timmy.
Well.
Zablon. Oh, Zablon's done well. Great defending from Zablon.
Oh.
Gabby does well as well.
Fantastic. So Kai's got it, gets it out to Omar. He's got Kelvin on his case. Oh, Kelvin's got it. Oh, that's a foul. That's a foul. That's a foul. He's got his arms in the air and stuff.
I should have given that. Sorry.
Hear that?
Lads are not happy.
You can kind of see the energy levels dropping. So what would you do now from the sidelines as a manager? And you're seeing the tempo. If the opposition were consistent with their tempo, but your team was kind of struggling or showing signs of fatigue, what would you do?
Depending especially on if the you're outcome. Behind. If we're behind, that's a difficult one. I would result to long ball more.
Really?
I'd result to having someone bigger up front. I'll result to having more of a target man instead of a bit of pace up front.
Sure.
So they can start hitting him and he can hold up the play and delay it a little bit more so for us to run off of him.
Mm-hmm.
If we were in the lead, I would result to having one person up front who's got a little bit of pace and maybe changing the formation.
Understood. Understood. So a question a friend of mine asked me when I sort of mentioned this. Oh, what's this? What are we doing? Oh, Will's got it out. Just about. So it's back to his defender. And Kai gets it good to Harry. Back to Kai. So yeah, someone just said to me, if you're doing a TV show, aren't you worried that your opponents will just study your episodes?
Let them study.
No concerns there, I see.
Let them study.
That brings us to the end of a very grueling 11v11 match. I can see that some of the lads are deflated. It's important that I raise all of their spirits because it's moments like this that can make or break a player. Feels like I'm in these streets alone, grinding with a hole from town ago. Yes. The lads return to the dressing room to cool themselves down. But the streets colder, 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 colder. Little homie on the corner. But now I'm all grown up, grown up, grown up, grown up. I do it for us, I do it for me, I do it for you, I do it for we gotta make it. We gotta make it. Ain't no stop until you make it. I've been running out of patience. In the next episode, I bring in my Coach's Corner co-presenter Ash, who's going to do a Q&A with the lads about their teammates. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can take me out of the streets, but you can't take the streets out of me. Can't leave out the family, anywhere I go I bring my team. We only fear God, we don't fear no man. That's my bros, them, that's my gang. We only fear God, we don't fear no man.